Sometimes you'll run into a situation where both the channel mask and the pen tool mask are not good options for separating an object from its background. This image of a cat is one of those situations. Because of the furry nature of this cat, you would definitely not want to use a pen tool to cut it out. The next option would be a channel mask. So let's have a look at trying out a channel mask on this image. First, I'll go to the channels and select the one with the most contrast between the cat and the background. They look very similar, but the reds seem to have the most contrast, so I'll copy that channel and use curves to make the whites whiter and the blacks blacker. You can see that we can get some good contrast that separates the cat from its background, except where there is concrete behind the cat. In all of those areas, the value of the concrete is so close to the value and the color of the cat that there is little to no contrast to use in masking. If we use dodge and burn to further darken the background while keeping the cat white, we run into some issues. The line between the cat and the background is hard to see, much less define. At this point, you would basically be creating the boundary line of the cat with your burn tool, which kind of negates the whole concept of even trying to use a channel mask. So we can see here that the channel mask is not going to work well for separating this cat from its background. Thankfully, there's a shortcut that we can use. It involves first using the pen tool to roughly cut out the cat, and then using the smudge tool on the layer mask to create the look of fur. Here's how that works. First, grab the pen tool and begin to cut out the cat. Around the areas where there's no visible fur, like the ears, the feet, and the whiskers of the cat, be accurate. Wherever the cat has visible fur, cut into the contour of the cat. This will leave a little bit of room to create the fur later on. Once you've closed the path, Command-click on it so that you can see the marching ants making a selection around the cat. Then you'll want to feather the selection by going up to the Select menu and then down to Modify, and then choosing Feather. For the radius, put 0.5 in the box. Then press the Add Layer Mask button at the bottom of the layer palette that turns your selection into a layer mask for that layer. Next, we're going to smudge the mask. Before we do that, we got to grab the smudge tool. It's located above the dodge and burn tools in your tools palette. You may have to hold down the square to find the smudge tool, as it's the third one down in the submenu. It looks like a finger pushing down on something. Once the smudge tool is selected, first, make sure that the tool options bar at the top of your screen is set the same as mine. First, I've chosen the number 14 spatter brush to use with the smudge tool. It is important that you use a brush that has some separation in the bristles to create the look of fur. And I've found that this spatter brush that comes by default with every version of Photoshop works pretty well for that purpose. Moving to the right along the tool options bar, for the mode, I've chosen normal. The strength option is set between 60 and 70%. Because we'll be working directly in the mask, I've left sample all layers unchecked, and I've left the finger painting box unchecked as well. Next, make sure that the layer mask on the layer Exercise Smudgeroo is selected and active. It's important to only smudge in the mask and not in the original image because smudging an RGB layer is an intensive process that'll slow down and sometimes lock up your computer. With the smudge tool and the layer mask selected, go over the outline of the cat where you want to create the look of fur. You'll have to get used to how the smudge tool works, and creating realistic fur will take some practice. Notice that you can smudge in both directions to create the fur. Don't smudge out pixels too far away from the cat, or you'll begin to see the background behind it. Try to follow the natural direction of the fur as it appears on the cat. Once you've finished and are happy with the results, grab a normal brush and go around the outside of the cat once more to fix the areas of the mask that you find mistakes with. You can see the effect of the smudge tool when we look at the mask by itself by holding down the Option key and clicking on the layer mask. Using this method is great for removing any furry animal from its background, but it's also good for people with short, spiky hair. That concludes this exercise. Don't forget to save your work before you move on.